And I'm going to try to make this camera last as long as I can today, but I thought maybe catching some of this crowd and some of the stuff at the beginning of the tournament might be something you guys would really like to see. For those of you who've never made it here, this is the first time I've ever done it. It really is amazing. Everybody here you talk to is like just ecstatic to me. Only six guys will move on, and I don't know that it, you know, people that don't make it are going to, you know, obviously be heartbroken over it, but they'll do their best to get back to this again. So it's really a great deal so far. So now everybody's just hoping to go out and catch some fish because this really is fishing real time.
Well, official time is 6:18.
Shut it out again. Have a good day.
But definitely not least, might be the last boat going out today, but it's going to be the first boat going out tomorrow from Ohio, Danny Ryan Jr.
Good luck, Danny.
Thanks. Seem like just like the right size, right profile, something. We're gonna have to get on the big motor to get back in the car. But in the hooks are really super sharp. I mean, like super sharp. So, Nutter, I know you don't do the Facebook thing and we're gonna put these out there, but I don't need to sharpen these hooks. Grimmins, we don't need to sharpen these hooks. There's one. Oh. Don't get tournament time in my boat on time. I gotta go, 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 go. Well, there's a good one. Oh, that's a keep. Oh, yeah. That's how I keep. Thank you. good one. Oh, that's a real good one. Come on. Oh, yeah, that's a good one. Oh, that's the best one. Yeah. Right move, baby. Right move. Right move. That's what we're talking about. Right there. Come in here and catch your fish. Those kind of fish, five of them get you to the classic.
Danny Ryan Jr., a member of the Bent Rod Bass Club. Once again, I want to thank everybody for cheering on our anglers here today and everybody watching online at bassmaster.com. Make sure to leave lots of comments. Cheer on your state or your country that's being represented here. 59 anglers out of 20,000. And six will remain at the end of this deal. Three fish here today for Danny Ryan Jr. 3 pounds, 13 ounces, put you in 42nd place. And tomorrow's another day. Rally Cap Day, try to get it done out there tomorrow.
Yeah, I had a real good day today. You know, each day I've gone out, I've found something out, done a little bit better. I had a good one come off right at the boat. So, you know, I would love to have that net, but hey, that's what we're getting ready for.
You know, the funny thing is that you say I would love to get the net, and I'll tell you that the Bassmaster Elite Series, they can't use a net, and one of the things that will blow you away, you talk to any of the Elite Series pros after they fished for a couple of years that had come over from FLW or whatever, they said the two biggest adjustments to get to is that they only have 2.5 days of pre-fishing, and there's no net. They said you can't believe the amount of giant fish that you had on, but just can't boat.
Well, I wouldn't say that was giant, but it was probably the biggest fish I've seen here in pre-practice or even in practice. I had two other ones that were real, real close. I mean, within a 16th of an inch for sure. Just wasn't close enough to bring it up. So just going to go out, put my head down tomorrow and see if I can get a little bit better fish. So.
All right. Well, congratulations on making it here.
I do want to say something. Yesterday, I mean, they're preparing to try to get to the Bassmaster class. And yesterday, this guy spent 2 or 3 hours of his fishing time helping one of the foreign anglers be towed up the river and sat there at a boat ramp until we were able to get him picked up and loaded up and wait and gave up his free fishing time.
True champion on and off the water. Congratulations on making it here. Ladies and gentlemen, that can
start the day number two. Sitting here in the boat yard. I'm actually boat number one today. I was the last boat out yesterday. I feel real good, actually. I should have had my limit yesterday. Had the best fish I've seen all week come off at the boat. It was just unlucky, you know, that's fishing sometimes. And had some other fish that were just real close to squeaking. I should have had about 7 pounds yesterday, which would have put me right near the top 2-3 in my region. I think I'm in 6th or something like that. So I feel like I can duplicate what I'm doing pretty much up and down the main river. It's a pretty simple deal. I'm looking for a very specific bait pattern, and when that bait moves in is usually when I'm catching. So I pulled in on a couple spots, caught some right off the jump, and then a lot of other spots I just kept my line wet. So we're gonna do the same thing today, cover a lot of water, hopefully get a little bit bigger bite and see how this deal shakes out. Wish everybody luck out here, but I really feel like that boy from Italy better catch him, because if he doesn't, I feel like I'm gonna. So we're positive, we're gonna go out there and have fun, stay safe. Thankfully the skeeter's getting us up and down the river pretty good. So we're gonna go do day two and settle it. All right. We'll check back later. might make it. I've actually caught out off the edge of a branch in any practice day that I've been. Oh yeah, he touches. Yeah. There's one. Oh yeah, that's a good one. Oh yeah, that's a real good one. Oh, come on, don't get me hung up. He's got me wrapped up. Yeah. I don't know if he keeps or not, but he felt bigger than that. Oh yeah, that's a keeper. Yeah. Started day three here today. I made sure I stopped in and said thanks to the service crew because they really hooked me up, gave me a breaker for my trolling motor, got my lights working for me when I broke one of them. They're really taking care of people. JJ Patton's leading our division. I'll say congrats to him. He had a good bag yesterday, pushing 10 pounds. He had some engine problems, and JJ and I have been kind of fishing the same waters. We're both pretty far down south. We're making that big, long run, and I'm going to kind of stay out of his way today out of respect. I think it's the right thing to do. He's got a good bag of fish down there. I'm going to stay a little bit north of him, see if I can catch him. If he has any problems, I'm going to make sure we help him get back to the ramp. Service guys think they got him up. He just had a bad fuel pump. But once again, I'm going to say thanks to all the sponsors. Monroe, Louisiana, Hampton Inn, you know, the hotels are really taking care of us, giving us breakfast every morning. The Bass team has been really, really cool. Those guys are at our beck and call. I mean, anything we need, they're trying to help us out. So, really, really top notch. All the volunteers out here, they've been super, super cool. I want to thank all my friends and family for sending me all my messages and, you know, wishing me best of luck and all that type of thing. It's really, really cool because you come out here and, you know, you're out here kind of by yourself. A lot of guys are out here by themselves. I'm fortunate enough that Brett and Al came down, and Al's a really funny guy, so we've been cutting up and having a good time. And then I can't say thanks enough to Brett. He's really done everything he can do to help me out down here. He's bought me fishing rods, he's bought me 1 ounce tungsten weights, spinner baits, run to the tackle shop for me, setting up the camera for me every day. Pretty much everything I need, this man's been over here to help me out. So, gotta really say thanks to him. So, I'm gonna go out there today though. I'm gonna try to stay out of JJ's way, but I'm still put my head down and try to catch some fish. I still think there's a limit of fish that I can find north of where he's at. So, we got some good footage coming your way. Hopefully there'll be some bloopers out there. I had quite a bit of weird things happen to me on the water this week. It's been the most amazing tournament I've ever had, but I had some weird things happen too. So we'll put some videos out here for you guys here in the near future. It's gonna take us a long time to go through all those hours and hours of film that we got down here. So we're probably about 25, 30 boats away from being in the water before they get this thing started. So just wanted to check in, say hi to y'all, and say thanks for everything, and we're going to go out and catch them today. All right, have a good one. All right, we finally get to the first spot. It's, I think it's 8:50. I hung out up north a little bit for the fog, and you know, I did that for a reason because I was trying to stay safe, but things always happen for a reason. And so I hung out up there a little bit, fished some stuff I really didn't want to fish, decided to come on down. And when I come on down, the Italian guy who's in second place in the Northern Division right now, he snapped a pin off inside the trolling motor. And of course, they don't have any tools or anything there. So we took it all apart, got the trolling motor back in working, and now he's back fishing again. So just thought we'd tell that little story before we start fishing. Right up here, I caught two right away, first spot, first thing in the morning yesterday, so let's hope we catch some. Spot. There's one. Oh, that one will keep. Hey, we got two in the box. Yeah, yes. We can at least hold up two fish at the weigh-in.
Third division from Ohio, member of the Bent Rod Bass Club. Give me a little love for Danny Ryan Jr. Once again, we are holding our sixth division leaders to weigh in last, and we are trying to fill all of these seats. Two open spots so far. And unfortunately, Danny Ryan Jr., a tough final day here. No fish, but the beautiful thing about the sport of fishing is we make you parade in front of people and talk about how you caught no fish. I mean, it's way more cruel than American Idol. We are the original American Idol, actually. But there's a lot of guys back in Ohio that wish they were here right now catching no fish, believe it or not, just because making it here is something that has to be commended for.
Well, I actually did catch fish today. They're all back in the drink because I came in 9 minutes late. The boat broke down on me. It's kind of funny because I think I fixed three boats on the water this week, one today. But hey, you know, that stuff happens. You know, I came in late. The rules are rules. So going back in the drink, and just wanted to say thanks to all the friends and family back home. I got a lot of messages, been really, really cool. Thanks for that pretty little girl out there putting up with me all the time, going out and doing this. Just really want to say thanks to all the BA.S.S. staff, and all the volunteers. You guys did an awesome job, kept us going. It was really, truly amazing. You know, the skeeter guy gave me two lights and a breaker to keep my trolling motor going. So, I mean, really, seriously, you should give yourself a round of applause. You guys really worked hard. So.
Well, thank you for being here. Congratulations. We look forward to seeing you back here again.
Day after day, I'm more confused. Yet I look for the light through the pouring rain. You know that's a game that I hate to lose. And I'm feeling the strain. Ain't it a shame? Oh, boys, and free my soul. I wanna get lost in your rock and roll.